Welcome, everyone, and good morning. Thanks again for being here and participating. As TR said, this is particularly timely that we're coming together given the more intense and more widespread recent public focus on the equity markets. I think as we get started here today, there's a lot we want to acknowledge. We share the goal of identifying the best paths, the best alternatives, and the best way forward for the equity markets. And today that'll be part of hopefully what we can begin to accomplish. And we can acknowledge that the equity markets have become increasingly complex and fragmented. I think there's agreement that our markets infrastructure should be more resilient. We know that the mechanism for disseminating market data should be revisited. And we can acknowledge that increased transparency and disclosure about order routing and execution practices would benefit investors and market participants. And at the same time, recent public conversation has landed on and raised some very valid questions. What is the market impact of the increasing volume of messaging traffic? Do the number of order types add to market complexity and provide advantages or disadvantages to certain market participants? And how is price discovery impacted by the increasing number of market centers? All of these factors, all of these questions, have sparked a discussion about fairness in the markets. Questions about fairness create uncertainty. Questions about fairness can really impair trust and confidence in our markets. As leaders in this area, it's critical for us to lead in developing workable market solutions. Investor trust and confidence in the equity markets, and the secondary markets in particular, is essential to an efficient financial system that can drive economic growth. And robust investor participation in the markets is critical to their success. It's what enables Americans to achieve financial security, makes it easier for companies to raise and access capital that they need to grow their companies and create jobs. And we know that the equity market structure is the result of a number of factors that have developed over the last several decades. Initiatives such as Reg ATS and NMS have created a regulatory imperative for competition and automation in the equity markets. In addition, technological advances have dramatically changed the business models and practices of market participants. These factors have spurred a tremendous amount of innovation that has made the U.S. equity markets extremely efficient and liquid. At the same time, however, markets operate at extremely high speeds through a complex network of trading venues. This is clearly not the structure we would have built were we starting from scratch, and we should be pushing ourselves as a collective body to see if we can do things better. SIFMA and its members have repeatedly called for a comprehensive review of equity market structure, both business practices and regulatory regime. And the recent public commentary shows the importance of acknowledging the complexity of the markets and the risks and perils of generalizing any conclusions or potential solution. At the same time, we know we're at a point where industry should take the lead in identifying specific market and regulatory enhancements for the markets, and at the same time, develop workable alternatives. We agree with SEC Chair Mary Jo White's recent testimony that any reform of the markets should be the result of a data-driven approach that relies on empirical evidence. Now, over the course of today's very strong program, our experts will address the major questions and considerations surrounding equity market structure. For example, we'll consider the current construct for distributing market data and the differences between SIPs and private data feeds. And SIFMA has raised concerns in this area, including the speed differences between public and private data feeds in our December 2013 letter to the SEC. Another question to consider: do we have the right incentives in place to ensure a healthy balance of exchange and off-exchange trading? There's been a lot of discussion about the interplay between the need to limit market impact of orders and the need to provide accurate and comprehensive, high-quality price discovery. SIFMA has supported FINRA's efforts to increase price transparency in this area and will consider whether additional transparency is needed. Another key question on today's program is whether the markets are too complex. In the quest to create competition and provide innovation, have we added unnecessary complexity that makes the markets less resilient? How does regulation play into this debate? For instance, is market fragmentation an unintended